The last segment which practices intellectual subversion. I particularly hold a very significant section of the IIT passouts who have relocated in the United States for this intellectual subversion. When I did some research on anti-Hindu non-government organizations, I found that most of these non-government organizations like AID, ASHA, Akhila Raman, Angana Chatterjee and the others are all well entrenched in American universities. These are communists who are functioning from American universities, who openly write in support of Naxalism, who have participated in the CPI-ML Congress. Mahashweta Devi, Arundhati Roy, Praful Bidwa, you name them, they have links with Naxals and they are all well entrenched either in American universities or encouraged by Indians, Indian communists from American universities. And a very large section, significant number, are IITians. Raju Rajagopal is an IIT, Ram Puniani is IIT, Sandeep Pandey is IIT, Balaji Sampath is IIT. There is a significant IIT component, the intellectual elite moving into intellectual subversion. What is the remedy? I'm afraid this is going to stick in the craw of most of us who think tolerance is our defining virtue. I'm afraid Hindu society forgot the valor of the Hindu Rajya, Samrajyas and Hindu society which staved off Islamic rule, which fought the colonialists, which is even today fighting the communists at the level of the society. Hindu intellectual elite has a self-imposed image of tolerance which is not real. We have forgotten the Kshatriya blood which is intrinsic to both our intellectual activity and to our public life. There is no Kshatriya blood in the leadership, Hindu leadership today. There is no Kshatriya blood. Sabarimala happened, Pujya Kanchi Acharya episode happened. There is an EVR statue right in front of the Srirangam temple. What is the response of Hindu organizations, the Hindu intellectuals and Hindu society? Has there been a response? Has there been an intellectual response? Has there been a physical response? There are very, very highly respected voices from amongst the Hindu community which is actually saying, we have no objection to the EVR statue anywhere in Srirangam, just not in front of the temple. We have forgotten the concept of temple town. The whole town is a temple. One of Vigil's members, when I said Hindu Rashtra, I mentioned territory. The territory also comprises the character and content of public spaces. Let me tell you the politics of public spaces and the intellectual subversion associated with it. In 1900, the Pope came to India 2 days before Deepavali, I think in 1999, and he declared his intention of planting the cross in Asia in the third millennium. The first victim of the church planting mission in Asia is South Korea. In 1900, South Korea was less than 1% Christian. In the 1970s, it was around 18.5% Christian. In 1990, it is 40% Christian. Just as what is happening to Kerala. I think in Kerala, according to somebody with whom I traveled by train, slightly over 50% is Hindus. The rest is all gone. Seoul City, from the heart of Seoul City to Seoul Airport, is a 20-kilometer stretch. On either side of this 20-kilometer stretch, at every 3 feet. There is a towering church at every 3 feet. And these are not the small prayer, Christian prayer houses with the asbestos sheet or a thatched roof. These are towering churches in the heart of Seoul to the Seoul airport. Scores of churches, completely disproportionate to the Christian population or the numbers of those who come to congregate in these churches. Then why are they standing there? Public spaces. The churches are standing there as a symbol of subjugation, as a symbol of dominance, as a symbol of money power, that I will occupy your public space. The presence of E.V. Ramasamy Naikar, I am 100% sure it is Christian money which has gone into the Dravida Kalgam, which has instigated them to plant EVR statue in front of the Rajagopuram. The land was allotted to them in 72. From 72 till this date, they did not dare to plant the statue there. There was continuous Hindu resistance. All of a sudden, how did they get the courage or the money to go and plant it? They did it in 2007, soon after the Kanchi Acharya issue, soon after the Sabarimala issue, soon after we showed them, you can keep on rubbing our noses in the dirt, the Hindu community is incapable of any kind of Kshatriya response. Towering churches in Seoul. You enter the Tambaram railway station by train, there is this huge cement pillar. On this huge cement pillar, there is a huge Jesus Christ standing like this. When you enter from a train, this is the first thing that you see. Yesterday, I was horrified when I came to the Madras Central Station. I think this must have come up about a month ago. I'm entering the Madras Central Station, right beneath the bridge, a huge cement pillar, a huge Jesus Christ outside the Central Station standing like this. Occupation of public spaces. This is a political intent. This is not a religious intent. I am dominating you. I am subjugating you. Do we have the sense to see this? I am told that the EVR statue in front of the Srirangam temple is not the only perversion. I believe on the Thiruvananthapuram beach there is a Devi temple. And right in front of the Devi temple, there is a 50-foot sculpture of a naked woman. Not far from the temple, there is also a church and a mosque. But this naked woman is standing not in front of the church or the mosque, but only in front of the temple. So when the communists speak of atheism, when the Dravidians speak of atheism, they don't speak of anti-Muslim God or anti-Christian God. It is only anti-Hindu. I disagree with Uday Nambudri ji when he talks about Islam. Islam is a threat which you see as a sword against which we still do not have weapons. Christianity is cancer. It invades your body. With sweet words, it tells you, I am a part of you, and then eats you away. Communism, of course, is a blight on humanity. I cannot have partnership with any of the three. And all the three inside India have intellectual backing. If Arundhati Roy can write a book for Afzal Guru, if Nirmala Deshpande and Mahashweta Devi, they have all been awarded the Padma Vibhushan by the Congress government. They participate in a Naxalite Congress. If Christian conversion can be legitimized by India's academia, the subversion of Indian nation, the Hindu Rajya and the Hindu Rashtra is backed only by intellectual subversion. If they are terrorists, blame us. We are happy victims of terrorism. What stops us from becoming Kshatriyas? What stops us from writing good books? What stops us from producing monographs which will threaten them? What stops us from physically removing these Jesus Christ statues and the EVR statue? Ask yourself the question and you will understand why intellectual subversion has worked in this country. The victims of intellectual subversion, unfortunately, is the Hindu Rajya and the Hindu Rashtra, and only Hindus have themselves to blame. Namaskar.